Oh, I didn't even have to. Oh, that's the one. It's nice. I was surprised.
Representative Brown.
Present.
Representative Shafi.
Present.
Representative Sabah. Excuse. Representative Labaca. Representative Fatima. Representative Juan.
President.
Representative Ferretta.
Present.
Representative Chaffee. It's gonna be late. Representative Thomas. Representative Patel, who's at this.
Thank you. The next order of business is reading and approval of the minutes. Please take this time to read over the minutes. Are there any corrections to the minutes? If not, the minutes will stand as approved. The next order of business is reading and approval of the agenda. Please take this time to read over the minutes. Are there any corrections to the minutes?
I motion to have Ray Joyce be as a guest speaker.
There's been a motion to add guest speaker to the agenda and add Ray Joyce as a guest speaker. Is there a second? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All that opposed, please say nay. Does anyone abstain? The ayes have it, this motion has passed. Are there any other corrections to the agenda?
Motion to amend Bill 2024-F5-1004 to the agenda. New business.
There's been a motion to add Bill 2024-F5-1004 under new business to the agenda. Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All that opposed, please say nay. Does anyone abstain? The ayes have it, this motion has passed. Are there any other corrections to the agenda? Okay. If not, the agenda will stand as approved. As for that bill, please send that in the convention. Okay. Now we can move on to the next order of business, which is public comment. Is there any public comment? If not, we will move on to the next order of business, which is guest speakers. President Fasak, can you please present our guest speaker?
This is our existing neighbor in our office, but I would love for Director Ravis to introduce herself.
Hi everyone, my name is Ray Joyce Spagulat. I am the Director of Student Leadership and Civic Engagement, and also your next door neighbor up in SCE. Third floor. I just wanted to introduce myself and let you know that I'm a resource here. At SLCE, we do a lot of leadership stuff. We have like an upcoming strengths workshop if anybody wants to do that. We have service. We have an upcoming give event this Saturday during family weekend. And we're going to Maxwell Street Garden if anybody wants to talk about that. But I do a lot of other engagement, which is primarily where I was coming here. We are actually with USG and SAC and Chicago Votes. We're doing Praying to the Polls next Wednesday. And then we're also doing a student dialogue this Tuesday. And we're trying to do this Pledge to Vote campaign to get as many who are eligible USC students to register to vote. I'm trying to be over my college right now because they're leaving us. So just to let you know, 2 years ago, 70% of the student population is eligible to vote, actually registered, but only 30% actually want to vote. So we're really trying to change those numbers. So any help that you all want to give, or if anybody wants to do any other initiatives, I am very welcome to your ideas. But I just wanted to let you know, see my face, and I'll try to study your faces from afar, and I will most likely forget your names, but I will try to remember later on. But please feel free to tap me if you have any.
Are there any questions for our guest speaker?
Yeah. Apologies if I didn't hear this a little time ago.
For which one?
For the garden.
Oh, the Maxwell Garden is at 2. Mm-hmm. It's right after the brunch.
I just have one question for voting. Are there any early voting booths
to register to vote because online voting registration ends on the 20th. Just know that because we're super strict, we're able to register to vote and vote at the same time. And even if you are, this is not your ward on election day because we're super strict, you can still come and vote.
Any last questions for our guest speaker?
So, Bill 2024-F4-1003, Spark Your Success event. So, chief sponsors, myself, President Assad, Treasurer Clement, Director Wayne, and Graphic Designer Ahmed Hadi, and co-sponsors, Vice President Haley and Chief of Staff Gregory. Whereas the undergraduate student government recognizes the importance of enhancing students' professional development and career readiness, and whereas the Student Success Committee seeks to create an engaging and impactful event for students to prepare for the fall internship and career fair, and whereas the Student Success Committee will host the Spark Your Success event in collaboration with UIC's Career Services on Monday, October 21st, 2024, at 11 o'clock a.m. to 3 o'clock p.m. SEE, offering professional headshots, resume reviews, and elevator pitch practice, allowing students to interact with recruiters and Career Services staff for the purpose of practice, then let it be resolved that USG volunteers will assist in managing and supporting the event to ensure a smooth experience for all participants. Let it be further resolved that the USG will actively promote the Spark Your Success event through social media advertising, email campaigns, and other marketing strategies with the USG logo featured prominently on all material to highlight the collaboration and support. Let it be further resolved that USG's role in the event will focus on providing volunteers and promotional efforts to enhance student participation and engagement. So this event is going to be next Monday in a week, Illinois Room, and I will be sharing a spreadsheet for you guys to sign up and during my report, but it's basically just going to be an opportunity to get your professional headshot, practice your elevator pitch, and get your resumes for you. So all PD focused, professional development. Questions?
Thank you. Are there any questions or amendments or discussion?
Okay.
Hearing none, I'll move on.
UIC Tailgate USG Participation. Chief sponsors are Vice President Haveli and Treasurer Klimek. Co-sponsors are President Assad, Graphic Designer Abdelhadi, Director Nair, Director Huang. Whereas the undergraduate student government participates and funds various UIC events throughout the year to provide opportunities for the undergraduate student body to be better connected. And whereas Homecoming Week is one of the most important traditions of UIC, while students interact with UIC student organizations, UIC administrations, and USC alumni at the tailgate, and whereas the undergraduate student government supports the student engagement and collaborates with student organizations to increase participation and flame spirit in the USC homecoming tailgate, then let it be resolved that the undergraduate student government will present the Flame Spirit Award to a registered student organization based on criteria such as most crowded, most prepared, and most alumni attended. The winning org will receive a $500 restaurant award in recognition for the contribution to student involvement. Let it be further resolved that the undergraduate student government shall allocate a maximum of $7,500 to cover similar expenditures that will occur in planning and participating in the tailgate and homecoming activities included in the list below, which is a cupcake fruit truck that we get every year for the tailgate, 600 cookies from DeWitt's Cookies, coffee, hot chocolate, hot tea, lemonade, a heated tent, and the award. Let it be further resolved that all unspent funds shall be returned to budget.
Thank you.
2024, as 5-2011. Chief sponsors is the Public Affairs Committee. Both sponsors, President Chad, Chief of Staff Hungary, and Vice President Belli. Whereas the undergraduate student government aims to represent students and advocate on behalf of their needs. And whereas USG seeks to continually improve and expand upon its initiatives based on student experiences and feedback. And whereas the Public Affairs Committee is tasked with the job of communicating information about USG events and activities to students, then let it be resolved that the Public Affairs Committee, UIC undergraduate student government, will host tabling sessions weekly or bi-weekly to facilitate communication with students, including requesting feedback and promoting upcoming USG events. Let it be further resolved that the tabling sessions will be varied in dates and timings, of which will be decided the week prior in coordination with the executive team in the House. Let it be further resolved, representatives from other committees will be encouraged to help with the initiative, and there will be a minimum of 2 USG executive cabinet members at all times of the day.
Are there any questions or comments regarding this bill?
U.S. Campus Safety Commission Virtualization Act of 2025. Chief sponsors are President Assad, myself, and Chief Sanchisa, and co-sponsors are Director Bennett. Whereas the undergraduate student government is an institution that advocates for student concerns and drives campus service and programs, and whereas campus safety is the top concerns of the student body and undergraduate student government members, and whereas numerous incidents that raise concerns about student safety, highlighting that existing campus services are not meeting the needs of students. Whereas the USC campus has had multiple amount of USC honors through the summer 2024 and during the first weeks of the fall semester, then it is resolved that the undergraduate student government shall continue to address campus safety by the observing the U.S. Economic State Commission for the 2024-2025 academic year, then let it be further resolved that the mission of the U.S. Economic State Commission is as follows. The U.S. Economic State Commission shall work to improve the safety of students and U.S. community members by meeting the administration's related to campus safety and concerns, ideas, and feedback from students on campus services. Data issued by this commission shall be reported back to the undergraduate student government to provide recommendations to the UIC administration. Let it be resolved, upon passing this bill, the undergraduate student government shall work immediately for the U.S. Chicago State Commission for 2024-2025 academic year.
Thank you. Are there any questions or comments regarding this bill?
Basically working on the concerns. It is not just like we have concerns this year and start at a time. We already have this commissioner. And they are really helpful for the improvement of safety for the students. The commissioner person will have instead of the administration related to safety. So basically it's like a director position, but they are going to have their OTs by
Bill 2024 F5 5003, USG participation in promotion of the UIC Bowling Alley Grand Reopening. Woo! Chief sponsors are President Assad, Vice President Zigali, and myself. Whereas the undergraduate student government recognizes the importance of fostering a strong campus community and supporting it as a united student body. And whereas the UIC Bowling Alley is an important recreational facility for students and has been underutilized in recent semesters. And whereas the undergraduate student government advocates for the reopening of the UIC Bowling Alley to enhance social spaces on campus and create more opportunities for student engagement. And whereas the Bowling Alley's grand reopening on Halloween Day provides an opportunity to increase visibility and student engagement with the facility, then let it be resolved the undergraduate student government will promote the grand reopening of the Bowling Alley through its official newsletter and Instagram page to encourage student attendance. And let it be further resolved, USG members will actively participate in a grand reopening event on Halloween Day from noon to 3 p.m. to demonstrate support for student recreational activities and enhance the visibility of the Bowling Alley as a valuable campus resource.
Thank you. I will now open up the floor for discussion. Are there any questions or comments regarding this bill? There are no further comments. We will be voting on this bill for next week. Our next item for discussion, or our next order of business, is ex officio reports. Maybe please have a report if you'd like.
Yeah, a couple of announcements. One that I alluded to last week, as of 12 o'clock today, the EPC application is live. So you're all probably wondering what the EPC is. It's the Election Planning Committee, which oversees the USG elections that are happening in April of next year. The USG elections consist of individuals being voted on for trustee, president, vice president, as well as the Senate positions, as well as the House of Representatives. EPC is responsible for the editing as well as the publishing of the EPC handbook, which is the running guide for the USG elections, as well as handling all complaints throughout the USG process. We have opened up the application. It'll be live for 3 weeks. So if you have individuals that you know that might be a good fit, please let us know. We are currently not accepting individuals that are already involved in USG due to conflicts of interest. If you have any questions, please let me know. I will not be overseeing EPC. That will be Kyle. So I will direct questions to her. The next part is the campus climate survey. It is live. So if you have not done so, please do so. And please promote that within your social groups as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any questions for the advisor? If not, the report of the advisor has been filed. Next, we have the report of the student trustee.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to week 8. It's so hard to believe that we're here right now, week 8, halfway through the semester already. It's absolutely insane, but so nice to see so many of you in this room. So I would love to have broken the news about the bowling alley, but fortunately you guys are already on that. But the bowling alley has been closed for the last 3 years. This has been something that student government has been fighting for nonstop, this entire time. So we finally got it reopened, and you know, cheers to that. Very happy about that. So, very excited. October 31st, hope to see you all there and every single day afterwards. So, as far as my report, you can take a look. I wrote on some of my notable meetings with the administration. Just want to highlight on a couple of things on top of the bowling alley reopening. So, I've been attending the advisory boards that I've been appointed to. So, first and foremost, I attended the Sustainability Fund Advisory Board's first meeting last week. Very nice to get to know everybody and understand what this board is. Actually, I found out that this board was due in part to the advocacy of the undergraduate student government around 2010. So it's really nice to be back and in that room and understanding, you know, how they're using these funds. Also, I've been attending the Student Fee Advisory Board meetings. We had our first one 2 weeks ago and another one last week. And I also participated in a transfer student research survey. Provided my input on how UIC can better support our transfer student population. I'm not a transfer student myself, but I've interacted with a lot, and just broadly speaking, I advocated for a larger sense of community for these people, like a greater support network, because we have pretty good support networks for our freshmen, but I think we need something better for our transfer student population. So that's what I talked about there. And then if you scroll to the bottom of my report, I have some opportunities. I'm thinking I'm going to try to include this as much as possible, as many events as I can. But on the first bullet point, you see UIC events. That's the UIC Today page, where they have every single event that UIC departments are planning. Keep an eye on this always. It's a really good resource to have. Beyond that, tomorrow there's a networking event with UIC alumni called Flames Connect. If you're going to go to that, be sure to register right now. I know there's over 200 students registered, so I'm not sure if it's still open, but take a look if you're interested. And finally, if you're interested in the transportation space, the Young Professionals in Transportation group is hosting a networking event. So again, if you're interested in transportation, might be able to make some good inroads there. But on top of that, there's Apple Harvest on the 17th. Krista, the dietitian from UIC Dining Services, mentioned that to us and asked us to promote it. So if you want to learn a little bit more about apples and get some fresh apples, that will be in the Student Center on that day. But that's my report. Thank you all very much.
we will open the application after the guild has. And yeah, and I will do more details, but it's open to everyone, it's open to student body and also you. Other than that, I met with the diversity inclusion director, Alto, to organize a Thanksgiving dinner reflecting on last year events with the new ideas and yeah, to make years even better. So I also organized the US Street Transportation with USD homecoming activities at the tailgate. This is also very, very exciting. I met with the treasurer of the night to plan logistics and the budgeting of the tailgate participation. And so what we decided is a cafe truck, this activities, promoting flame spread to student organization, which we will have a $500 award for the winning organization. This means that I know all of you are like great leaders of the student body, so if you're in any other organization, please promote it to them so maybe you guys can have a nice dinner together. Other than that, alumni engagement, we are working on that right now, and coordinating for the meetings and collaborations. Again, I encourage all your student members to promote and attend both the Flame Fest and tailgate. The Flame Fest will be next week, which is pretty soon. We have one more GPM before that, but Michael will announce like the spreadsheet about doing volunteering. So if you're interested in, please let us know, put your name down. And other than that, I will be around after the GPMN. So if you have any questions, if you have any ideas, or want to volunteer in any of those events, please come and we will talk. Thank you.
Do we have any questions for the Vice President? If not, the report of the Vice President will be filed. Next, we have the report of the Treasurer.
Happy GBM 5, everyone. I hope everyone's midterms have been going well, that they're starting to wrap up. For tonight's catering, we have Chipotle chicken burritos, bean and rice burritos, which are vegetarian, tortilla chips with salsa and guacamole, and then chicken, cheese, enchiladas, Caesar side salad, and assorted cookies. And then we also have a little bit of lemonade as well. So otherwise, if you did get a chance to last week, please fill out this form for any dietary restrictions you might have. And for my updates, we're still looking for more volunteers for Flames Fest next week. We need 6 volunteers every hour, so please fill that out and put in your availability. Otherwise, I worked with the LIE to plan USG's participation in the tailgate, and work with Quinn Vasta as well with that, ordered our catering for next week, and then I had breakfast committee meeting and worked on our positions there. And then a budget update as well. You can see most of our spending has been in events and discretionary being our room and then our catering for the semester, and events being the Flames Fest so far. We still have a lot to spend this semester, roughly about $20,000-ish. So think of those resolutions. And then some opportunities to USG Flames Fest, even if you're not gonna volunteer, we wanna see everyone there in participation, and then also the tailgate in a few weeks as well. Please email me if you have any questions.
Are there any questions for the treasurer? If not, the report of the treasurer will be filed. Next, we have the report of the speaker. Happy GBM 5, everyone. It's the middle of the semester. I smack down the middle. Take care of yourselves during cold and flu season and take time to relax, as we're all flooded with interns. Congratulations to interim speaker Satchel.
CLC director there. This weekend meeting, I've already actually met with LAC director Giorgio. I'm going to be meeting with director Clement, and also through meeting with director past meetings. This week I met with director Thokadu Biapu and President Saad to discuss initial steps to getting the ball rolling on our BSMS program for psychology. And I'm also coordinating a meeting with President Saad and Vice President Dubelli with UIC dietitian Krista to bring back our new psychology. If you have any questions or have any things that you want to discuss with me, please feel free to reach out to me.
Are there any questions for the chief of staff?
I've been much familiar with the meals calculation program. It sounds really self-explanatory.
Yeah, so basically it was a program last year that was brought in by the former president and his team that students who at the end of the school year didn't lose their meal swipes were able to donate them to students who didn't need them. So like, if you live in campus housing, you're required to have a meal program, but not all students like use every single one of their swipes. So instead of going to waste, it's a way to like to repurpose those swipes. I'm pretty sure they carry over for a year.
Okay.
So yeah.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions for the chief of staff? If not, the report of the chief of staff will be filed. Next, we have a report of the diversity and inclusion committee chair.
Hello, everyone. So this week, I have been speaking to Chicken and Mr. Pizza, and I agree on the class and upcoming priorities. I also met with the diet, the right fitness to discuss upcoming issues, especially the Thanksgiving event. On top of that, like this upcoming week, I'm in the process of shipping a meeting with UIC building to discuss ways of enhancing the international student experience. And today I had my second committee meeting, and we're just deciding on deputies coming soon. And that's pretty much it. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out on my email or you can ask right now.
Are there any questions for you guys in the room? If not, the report of the diversity and inclusion chair will be filed. Next, we have the Legislative Affairs Committee chair.
Hi, everyone. Not a lot has changed since last week, but I met with President Saad and former President Almendros today about lobbying ideas, and we talked about other ideas for LAC, including the lobby day that a lot of people are still interested in from last year, and then other bill tracking and legislative updates. And then I met with the Chief of Staff Gregory for our weekly meeting today, and then part of the polls event and bill will hopefully be available at the next PBM. And then we had our second LAC meeting, and everyone's been bringing great ideas and proposals for LAC to accomplish this school year, so it's really exciting. And if you guys have any questions or want to be involved in anything, feel free to reach out.
Are there any questions for the LAC director? If not, the report of the LAC director will be filed. Next, we have the Public Affairs Committee Chair.
Happy GBM 5, everyone. It's great to see you guys. This week, we finished the representative intro post, and we started posting them. So as they get posted, make sure you're reposting them on your story and liking and commenting on them. We also finalized the Delta PAC statement. We had our first PAC committee meeting last week, so we started planning our newsletter, future tabling to promote different events and merch designs. I checked in with graphic designer Ajda Ali about Fall Fest graphics and some other projects that are upcoming. And then I had my chief of staff check in with our email meeting. So if you have any questions, feel free to email me.
All right. Are there any questions for the PAC director? If not, the report of the PAC director will be filed. Next, we have the student success
happy GBM5. So next week is the Spark Your Success event on Monday, October 21st, 11 o'clock a.m. to 3 o'clock p.m. Basically, I already explained the event, but I just sent you all an email with a spreadsheet that you guys can go ahead and put your availability in if you are interested in volunteering. I hope all of you join the event. Even if you don't want to volunteer, but if you are free and you want to volunteer, please just head over to that spreadsheet really quick right now and just put in your availability just so that I can send over some numbers over to the Career Services Executive Director so she knows how many volunteers we can expect as well. And if you have any questions, shoot me an email. And on November 11th, we did get the date confirmed. It's going to be the USG Coffee, Cocoa, Cookies, and Careers event. So stay tuned for more information about that. But I met with Chief of Staff Program President Assad to discuss some joint PS/MS stuff in psychology program, and also met with President Assad to discuss a rapid response tutoring system that we're thinking about implementing and seeing the possibility of implementation. Just met with the biweekly Chief of Staff check-in with Chief of Staff Herbery, and if you have any questions, want to be involved in anything, please feel free to text me, shoot me an email, or have a conversation with me. Thank you.
Are there any questions for the Student Success?
Or the pool setting or a campus cleanup on Thursday from 5 to 6. So if you want to show up, we're meeting at the quad. So yeah, going off to the
Korean American Student Association is having a game night this Thursday at Grand Hall 308, 5 to 7 p.m. So if you guys want to show up, there's free food, free snacks, play some games with friends, bring some friends. It's going to be a good time, so make sure to go.
I found out about an event today. It's on the 17th, 3 to 4:30 p.m. at the Latino Cultural Center, which is in the quad. A bunch of environmental organizations are going to get together to talk about the Chicago's Clean and Affordable Buildings Ordinance and how students can get involved in supporting Chicago's environmental legislation. So.
And that's
yeah.
There's a faculty residence that lives in my building that's hosting an event that's open for all students. It's in Lecture Center D, classroom one, number one. And it's actually, we're having a presentation by Kim Castro. She was a former FBI agent, and she's giving a presentation on those of you who might be interested in becoming a special agent. So I thought that was really cool. Interested, it's from 2 to 3 on the 16th on Wednesday.
Any other